Hey, hi everyone, welcome to Age Automation. Guys, in session number one, we have seen the things we required for getting started with our Selenium scripting. So we need Eclipse ID. For running the Eclipse ID properly, we need a Java installed. Okay, for that we have downloaded the GRE file, and also we have set up the environmental variables. Okay, so that we have covered. So in session number two, okay, I have divided this session in two parts. Part one, we are going to see some brief history about the Selenium. Okay, when who developed the Selenium and what year the Selenium was actually released. Okay, those kind of thing. Okay, also we will see why the name Selenium is given to this project. Okay, and after that we will go to Selenium website and let's see what things are available. Okay, on their official website. And part two, we will be discussing about the difference between Selenium Java project and Selenium Maven project. Okay, so I will be explaining what it makes Selenium Maven project to be an ideal choice over the Selenium Java project. Okay, so that will be in part two. So let's start with our part one. Okay, so I'll be explaining through some diagrams so that it will be easy to understand. Okay, so nowadays in interview also people are asking about some historic questions about the Selenium. Okay, the people names who developed and the year. So it is you must know about these things. So basically Selenium primarily developed by the guy who was working in a ThoughtWorks company. Okay, he was working in a ThoughtWorks company as an engineer, and he realized that whatever approach he was using, okay, whatever manual approach he was using for testing the things, okay, it was very time consuming and inefficient. Okay, so he developed one program, a JavaScript program, which can automatically controls the browser actions. Okay, and he gave the name to the program as JavaScript test. So he gave name as a JavaScript test runner. Okay. Okay. It was developed by the Jason McGinsey in 2004. Okay. So he created one JavaScript program and he gave the name as JavaScript test runner. So meanwhile, in 2004 to 2006, okay, four more major components of the Selenium were developed. Okay, so four more components, like let's create by one. Okay, so first component, which was developed by Paul Hammond, Selenium RC. Okay, the next component was Selenium Grid. Okay, Selenium Grid basically used to run your Selenium script parallelly. Okay, multiple script parallelly, and it was developed by name is Patrick Lightbody. Okay, who developed the Selenium Grid. Then a guy from Japan whose name was Shinya Kastani, who developed the third component, which was a Selenium IDE. Okay, so Selenium IDE is basically a record play, works on the record and play mechanism, which is a extension to the Firefox browser, and which can automates browser actions for only Firefox. Okay, it is limited to the Firefox only. So the fourth component, okay, the major component of the Selenium project, a web driver. Okay, So this fourth component was developed by Simon Stewart in 2006. So if in interview, if anyone asks you who developed the Selenium web driver, so you should say Simon Stewart, not the Jason Huggins. Okay, so Jason Huggins just started with the Selenium project, but Selenium web driver was developed by Simon Stewart in 2006. So after later after this web driver, in meanwhile, in after 2 years, this whole team, they started working together and they decided to merge two components to create a major one, that was the Selenium 2. So they decided to merge Selenium RC and Selenium WebDriver. Selenium RC. So they decided in 2008. They started working on this, merging these two and to get some stable version of Selenium 2. And in some around 2011, they developed, they released a stable version of Selenium 2. The stable version of Selenium 2 was released in June 2011, and just after the 2 years of this, the team started working on the Selenium 3. And in 2013 they announced that they are going to develop a next version of this project, the Selenium 3, which will be upgraded version of Selenium 2, a major bug fixes, and which will support the W3C standards as well. So in around around October 2016, they released Selenium 3, a stable version of Selenium 3. So and now we are hearing the news about the Selenium 4 as well. So Selenium 4 will be released. Let's see when it will be released, but it will be released with the new Selenium IDE, upgraded version of Selenium IDE, and some improvements and bug fixes for the Selenium 3. So we are waiting for it. Let's see when they will release the stable version. We will make a video on that separately in coming time. So Selenium, basically what exactly it is, Selenium WebDriver is nothing but a it is just an interface. When Selenium 3 was designing Selenium 3, there itself they said that if you want to interact with the actual browsers, you need to install a third party web browsers or drivers, web browser drivers. So just so Selenium, as I said, is a web driver interface. So if you know the some knowledge about the Java, you will come to know that if it is an interface, you can only have some the methods, method declaration inside that, and we need to implement the logic, logic and the code for those methods in the implementation classes. So that was developed by the third party drivers. So if you want to interact with actual, there are different browsers available in the market. Let's say we have I browser. Okay, we have Chrome browser, we have I Opera browser, we have HTML unit browser, also we have Android. Okay, let's see. So if you want your Selenium script or Selenium WebDriver to interact with actual WebDriver, you need to install some third party browser drivers on your system. Okay, so if you want to interact with Firefox driver, you need to install Firefox driver. Okay, good driver, what we said. Then if you want to interact with Chrome, you have to install Chrome driver. Okay, similarly for other browsers as well, there are these drivers are available on the Selenium official website. So in coming videos we will see how to download it and how to interact with the actual browser using these drivers. Okay, so one more thing that I want to tell you, why the name Selenium, okay, it is given to this project. Okay, so when meanwhile when Jason was on the in his team, they were developing the Selenium, so one more automation framework tool was there. Okay, the name was like Mercury. Okay, Mercury Tactic. Okay, so this was very popular by that time. Okay, so Jason and team, they decided like, why not, okay, they think out of the box and they decided, okay, let's give some an ideal name. Okay, so Mercury in medical term is okay, HG. Also if your body get infected with the mercury, okay, it's a poison. So if you want to get rid of mercury, you need to give an injection of Selenium. Okay, that's the only way. Okay, so they decided, okay, we will release this project with the name as Selenium. Okay, so whatever people, you know, they think, the people who are working on Selenium Mercury Interactive, okay, they think in the market there is another tool, and they release the Selenium, okay, Selenium 3 as open source. Okay, you don't need any pay any money for that. You just have to, you know, basically Selenium is just an available in the form of API, so you just have to download the jar files, okay, and add those external jar files to your Java project. Okay, and your script is ready to interact with your web browser. So okay, so you will see in coming videos how we are going to see that. So this is how they give the name to Selenium, okay, opposite to just Mercury. Okay, so it's come out one of the joke, but nowadays and till now Selenium is most popular and widely used in the current market to create automation framework. Okay, so in this video I have covered whatever topic we are planning to discuss. Okay guys, let's quickly go to the Selenium official website. So just go to browser and write Selenium HQ. Okay, so the first link, just hit that link. So this is the official website of the Selenium. So they have clearly mentioned that Selenium automates browsers. Okay, so you can only automate the web browsers, okay, web actions. And in the documentation tab you can see that they have provided a very good documentation as well. Okay, so they have mentioned that it will support Java, C Sharp, Python, Ruby, this type. These are the languages which Selenium supports. In download section, we can see that the latest version is 3.141.59. So in next video we are going to see how we can, you know, creating a Java project, we need to download the Selenium, and also we need to download the drivers, okay, to interact with the actual web browser. Okay, so that's it for this video. If you have any question or query, write email on ageautomation09@gmail.com. Thank you.